Repeat what I said before.
Declan, okay, what's going on, brother? You good?
All good, all good.
Happy days, mate. Happy days. So you're going to tell us a wee bit about your time here at Elite, yes?
Yep, I am indeed.
All right, good stuff, mate. Good stuff. So, right, before we get into that there, what was life like beforehand? What was going on? And what sort of plan did you think about doing the course?
Well, what was happening beforehand was not. I'm working still in the job that I'm in now. I'm a courier driver, so I've been working full time throughout the whole lockdown as well.
Mm-hmm.
But outside that, nothing really. Obviously, because the gyms are closed, and that's the case where most businesses at the minute. But I've got kettlebells at home, so I was kind of keeping myself fit in that way.
Uh-huh.
In terms of the course and what drove me to go on to it, I was actually meant to go on to it the year before, so last March. But the doubting voice in my mind kind of kept me away from it.
Right,
it always happens in that way, but I was glad to get on to it this time. And maybe it was meant to happen because the way I've met everybody in here sounds anything. So
yeah.
I'm glad I'm in this group.
Nice one, mate. What was anything that prompted you to do it this time around? Like, because a lot of people were like just thinking about it over lockdown or whatever. What was going on there?
Sometimes you just get away a bit of an itch to do something, and it kind of your subconscious is telling you.
Right.
But in terms of what I want to do with my life, I want to know this stuff. I want to know it in depth because I've never had much consistency with my own training, and that was probably half of it. I wanted my own knowledge to do things with myself,
right,
and close friends and family members that I would like to coach to a bit of health and fitness. In terms of my job, I'm not going to leave that anytime soon, so this is kind of just going to be something on the side that I want to progress and grow organically over time. You know?
Nice one, mate. So, I mean, you had no intentions of leaving the job or anything like that, so was there anything like you were sort of skeptical of about doing the course? Because a lot of time people are like, right, I want to go to this job, and then maybe they're just a wee bit wary about, you know, am I going to be able to pay the bills and all this here sort of stuff. So was there any of that going on? Or
the only skeptical thing was because I just had a daughter, 7 months, she's coming 7 months at the end of this month.
Right.
I was skeptical about my time and time management and stuff and how I was going to do things and fit it all in. I've also just I made a decision at the start of last week to contact a coach for myself to give myself more accountability and consistency.
Nice.
So the thing around that was, how will I fit all these things in? Everybody has that worry, how are you going to do so many things at once? But what I realised was, when I was doing these things, is I'm now cherishing more time at being a wee bit more relaxed with things, even though there's less of it. The novelty wears off when you've too much of anything, obviously, but with training and with this and with work and with my daughter, now I don't get time to do much outside that, but the much outside that was distraction anyway. You know?
Yeah, you find a nice
stuff.
Balance.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, mate, so was there a sort of point where you realised you had made the right move, a point during the course or anything like that?
Mate, to be honest, I came in on the, was it Tuesday night we were in, first?
Yeah.
And you could tell the nerves were hanging off everybody.
Yeah.
And then you told us that we were going to do the kind of initiation type thing, the introduction to ourselves. And I thought about that all week. This is why I wanted to do this video first, because usually the thought before an act is actually worse than the act itself.
Yeah.
I just wanted to get this out of the way. But it's, now I'm in it, it's good. It was the same thing with the introductions. When we were all introducing ourselves, I wanted to go up first. Somebody, I can't remember who it was, got in front of me and was fucking raising it. But I got in anyway, I got it done, and done it. And after, everybody else came after, I was like, Jesus Christ, there's so many stories and so many layers of why people want to do things. And from then on, I was like, this is brilliant, because the ice had been broke and everybody was just connected then, you know?
Nice.
So that was when it was the first week.
Nice, love it, mate, love it. What specifically, what's been your biggest takeaways from the course? What's been the sort of specific results for you personally?
For me, the ability to see somebody doing something, and even though it might look great, you could be so much better with just simple cues. So in terms of the coaching side of things, there's a lot of fluff around the health and fitness thing because it's so new and so young, obviously. But in terms of just the power of it, the coaching, I've been paired up with Owen, and it's been brilliant. When we're doing certain movements and certain exercises, things that I've been doing for years, and then I'm getting coached through them, and I'm going, Jesus Christ, I've been doing that fucking wrong. And I've probably been telling people how to do it, but it was actually wrong in the first place. So that's a big takeaway. Just the fact of communicating with everybody from around as well, it's good. It's kind of a getaway from the whole lockdown thing as well.
Nice.
Obviously, people's been stuck in the house and it's been a bit maddening, but this has been a good release, so I'm working all week. I'm looking forward to this on a Saturday. Usually, I would put myself into something and get a negative feel on it. But this, I'm loving it. Every time it comes out Friday night, I'm looking forward to coming in on a Saturday, so it's good that way.
Nice one, mate. Who would you recommend do this course? Like, I suppose if someone was sitting there kind of thinking, maybe they don't really know what to do with themselves, they kind of want to understand a wee bit more, maybe they don't want to leave the job, like that type of person.
Hand in hand, aye, well, because people that are in this kind of thing with their own health and fitness, that's what drove me on at first. Maybe I won't become a full-time coach, but it doesn't matter to me because I'm gaining knowledge of the things that I like to do anyway. I want to live the life of training consistently and being in good health until I'm old. I don't think enough people have that view, and if you can show them the way of doing that, then it will be beneficial to everybody. But people that I would recommend it to anybody, because even if you didn't want to become a full-time coach, you could tell somebody, just go and learn for yourself, and they will get a lot out of it, because it's a long enough course, and what you've been showing us, even on the Tuesday nights with Jane, with the physiology, and you on the Saturdays with the coaching, it's in-depth, and the things that you'll start to learn about what your body can actually do and what it can achieve is way above and beyond what society tells you. So,
love it. Thank you so much, buddy. Much appreciated.
100%. Thank you.